Hello, manifestors. So how do we manifest? How have you manifested your current circumstances right now? I think it's time to go back to the basics because I see a lot of you doing a lot of damage control. And it's not by doing damage control that we manifest our desires, especially if we have a lot of resistance towards our desire. So be sure to listen in all the way to the end of this video because this is going to be helpful. This is going to be an eye opener. And if you like the video, please be sure to like it. Subscribe if you are new here. Comment and share the video if you can so more people can learn how to become master manifestors. My name is Sylviane. I am a manifesting coach. I also have a blog where I write about the law of assumption. I have a podcast every Tuesday. I have a free Facebook group, Manifesting Group, according to the law of assumption and the teaching of Neville Goddard. And I have a paid membership Facebook group as well. And all the links are down below in the description box. So, how do we manifest? How did you manifest your current circumstances? Well, we manifest what we believe to be true, what we assume to be true, what we have felt to be true, what we have imagined, consciously or unconsciously. Basically, when we have a thought long enough that thought incurs a feeling, some type of feeling, belief, or assumption, it will manifest. And finally, the state that you are in will manifest. Because the state that you are in will actually control the thoughts and feelings that you have. In other words, if you are not in the state of your wish fulfilled, no matter what that is, well, your thoughts and feelings will not match having your desire. So this is very important to understand this as a start. So with this in mind, why are we using techniques? Whether it's SATS, whether it's I Remember When, whether it's the Isn't It Wonderful, whether it's any type of affirmations that we want to include in our daily mental diet. Why are we using techniques? We are not using techniques as damage control. We are using techniques to put us in the state of having our desires. And the reason why you are using techniques wrong, and a lot of times it would probably be affirmations more than anything else. Even though I know for a fact that people are doing this damage control with SATS as well. But whatever it is, it's when you are using the techniques as damage control rather than truly using the techniques to change your concept of self. Because, for example, if you are using affirmations as damage control, so for example, you are manifesting a specific person, but you have thoughts of, I feel lonely, I feel single, I don't feel loved. If SP wanted me, they would be here by now. I haven't heard from them in such a long time, I don't think they want me after all. If you have thoughts like that, what does that mean? It means that you are not in the state of your wish fulfilled. And if you are not in the state of your wish fulfilled, is that you are imagining the opposite of what you want, of your desire. What is your desire in this case? In this case, your desire is to be in a relationship with your specific person. But if you have opposite thoughts, it means that you are not living in the end of your wish fulfilled. You are not in the state of having or being who you want to be or have. Because your thoughts will always let you know in what state you are in. So let's say you realize that you are not in the state of your wish fulfilled because you have contradicting thoughts. Thoughts of anxiety, fear, everything but the type of thought that you should have. So now, because of it, you are throwing some affirmations to feel better. And guess what? You are going to feel better. Because that's what affirmations do. They do make you feel better. But do not be fooled. Because if you are using affirmations as a damage control to feel better because you have negative and opposite thoughts, you are really treating the symptoms rather than the cause. And what is the cause in such a case? What is the cause of having negative and opposite thoughts? Well, the cause is the state that you are in. What you are imagining day in and day out without even noticing. Neville said, "We think from ideas that we consent to as true, and we imagine situations that match our beliefs." So what you are imagining provokes those thoughts that are negative and opposite, which means that you are in an opposite state than the state that you should be in. So what does it mean? It means that you are not in the state of your wish fulfilled. You are actually in a complete opposite state. So if you throw affirmations just to feel better, but without taking care of the root of the problem, so to speak, you are treating the symptoms rather than the cause. And by the way, I'm talking about affirmations here, but some people do the same with SATs and other techniques. They are using the techniques as a damage control, as a treatment for the symptoms that they have, rather than using the technique to put themselves in the state of the wish fulfilled. In the state of having and being who they want to be and have. So if you are in the habit of using techniques as damage control, you need to remember this is not the goal of using techniques. Neville taught techniques to embody the feeling, not for damage control. Remember that, guys, next time you're doing this. Techniques are not meant to be used as damage control. I am not in my state. I am actually in a complete opposite state, but I'm going to use my techniques. I'm going to use my affirmations, my SATs, whatever other techniques as damage control. This is not how it works, guys. And this is what I am noticing more and more. I am noticing more and more people doing damage control on a regular basis because they are not in their states. And this is not the goal, guys. This is not how we manifest. And this is why you are still after your desire. However, manifesting never stops. So you do manifest. But if you are single and you want your SP, well, you are still manifesting being single. If you are broke while wanting to manifest money, well, you are still broke, and so forth and so on. Because you are manifesting whatever matches the state that you are in right now. So in other words, your damage control techniques, they're not useful at all. Are they? I know they're not. Because I speak to you guys every single day. And if you are doing this for a while now, stop, because you are wasting your time. Here's a quote from Neville. "That which is confronting you in your world now is the result of your past thoughts, beliefs, feelings, and imaginal activity. These appearances will continue in being as long as you give them life through your conscious awareness of them." You must disregard the evidence of your senses as it pertains to any undesirable condition in your life. You must imagine and feel that you have already attained that which you want to experience rather than that which you do not want to continue in being. This may appear difficult, yet you have probably exercised this principle unconsciously to produce negative results. So, according to this quote here from Neville, what you keep on thinking, believing, feeling, and overall imagining, because that's what thinking, feeling, and believing are. The whole thing is imagining. What you keep on imagining, whether it's consciously or unconsciously, will keep on manifesting in your life. So guys, instead of pulling a technique as a damage control, as a treatment for your symptoms, being, I'm not in the state, I'm imagining things I don't want. Instead of trying to treat the symptoms, ask yourself the question that will take you to the source. And the question is, why? Why am I still thinking from the opposite state that I should be in? Why is that? Ask yourself the question and answer the question. Why? Why are you still in an opposite state? And use your technique or techniques to embody the feeling, not as damage control. Let it stick into your head forever after you've watched this video, guys. Techniques are not damage control tools. We don't do SATs as damage control. We don't do affirmations as damage control. We do them to embody the feeling, to train ourselves, to train our mind, to train our imagination, to feel that we already have our desire. Unless you do this, manifesting a specific desire and especially a specific person and money, for example, which are the two things that we have the most resistance against, and maybe you can throw health in there. Manifesting those quote-unquote big desires would be very difficult indeed. If you keep on trying to put a band-aid on the issue, take the issue at the root and heal the issue from the root instead. Practice imagination. Practice meditation. And don't be triggered by the word meditation. Meditation is imagination. It's the same thing. And practice your techniques. But in order to embody the feeling, embody the state that will match your desire. I hope this video was very clear, guys, and I hope that it will help all of you who are doing damage control day in and day out, as I see you are doing every day. Again, this is a video I've never heard anywhere else. I hope you like it. If it was helpful, comment and share it so more people like you can learn how to become master manifestors. Thank you for listening, and I'll see you next time. Bye bye for now.